So if a jazz player plays a blues, then you might expect to hear a stream of notes. So you might... like that. But if a blues player plays a blues, you're going to hear... So the thing about that is almost every note I'm playing is bent or vibrato or has got some other thing to it. I think it's arguable that that's almost more important than the notes. And I think that relates to what I said earlier about the way that jazz players, you know, are all concentrated on the chords and all the complex stuff, whereas the blues players are a bit more, no, just play the scale and mess around with it. Because it's that feeling of it and the way that you manipulate the notes, I think, has more significance than the notes you choose in many ways. Not completely, but in many ways. So just applying this to what I've given here. So for example, we've got this lick here that I've written at the beginning, which is written as like that. Now, if I was playing a lick like that, I would probably play it something more like that. So it's not the notes that there, you see, it's all those little inflections. Now, these are things that some of you may be familiar with, like doing things like grace notes, where you're putting a note just before the note. So, for example, instead of playing at the beginning of that lick, you might play... So I've put another note just before the first note, like that, to make it sound like a scoop, like that. And of course, it is possible to bend notes on the saxophone, although I have no technical knowledge about that whatsoever. so that instead of you get, so there, I'm making a true glissando. Rather than ba-bam, so it's not like a piano key, but it's like a slide down like that. These are the kind of things that if you are interested in blues, that these are the kind of things that are going to be important to work on, those kind of specific techniques.